Hi all, and welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition. On the last episode, we talked to Horsemaster Dennett and got ourselves horses for the Inquisition, not to mention Dennett himself, to join the Inquisition. I figured today what we're going to do is we're gonna start with a couple of these courses. These horses for courses, courses for horses. And just kind of see how fun that is. Sure, let's talk.
Fancy trying out one of my courses?
Didn't you just say that? Explain the races.
What kind of racing are you talking about?
I set up a course over there with stakes in the ground. It's too narrow to race directly, so I time it with a sand glass. You try to ride the course before I call time.
Alright, I'll give it a try.
I'll try one of your courses.
Wonderful. Get your horse and I'll set up the stakes. You make time, I'll throw in some of the dress money Father gave me. Consider it a donation to the Inquisition.
There's our start. So I assume it's all going to appear on the radar as we go. Get a running start. Ride between the posts. Yeah, let's celebrate by rearing up and accidentally crossing the girl. That would be fantastic.
Nicely done. Fancy another race?
No, I'm good.
I'll speak with you later.
Assuming there's a bunch of races we've got to do, but we're not going to do those. We're going to actually look for a little bit of other stuff to do here. And we got Ocularium. Templars. Let's deal with this Templar issue. Let's see what we can do with this Templar issue here. I don't normally like doing this mounted. I don't know, I just feel like I'm missing out on possible items. Lots of them. Okay, this is going to be a big area by the looks of it. I'm just going to dismount here. Somewhere. Is that one of our watchtowers? Is that what they look like when they're built? I think this is where we put up a watchtower, isn't it? Yeah, it's one of the Inquisition watchtowers. Hey, how's it going? Can I go in it? Sir. Hop it? No. Just stand around it, I guess. That's cool. I didn't really assume it would be like a permanent change to the landscape, and as small as it is, it's still kind of cool. I see Templars. Let's, come here. Oops, I have stamina. Circle around. Archers over here. Ah. Okay, so not quite as quick to bounce back after that.
Pathetic little bastard.
Shield strike there. There's a potion here. Get Cassandra to pop a potion as well. So where do we pull these guys down from? Up over here? Let's head up over this way. Ooh. Loot. Always nice. Sailing blade. Kind of seems like a path. Could just be a discovered Templar encampment. That's a good sign.
The Templars have secured a position ahead.
Thanks, Cassandra. That is not what I meant to do, but I'll take it. Cyrus, you really need to do something with that low health that you constantly need to have. Seems like there's quite a lot of them around us. Hoped. Last episode I felt like I was getting the hang of the combat. This time I definitely feel out of practice. I'm not even really looking. Royal Elfroot. I wonder what that's about. I'm kind of expecting to find one of those loot search things. Quite tough.
Safer on the King's Road now.
We must still deal with the apostates, however.
That looked like rare gear. Let's take a look at that. Swedish fingers. No, I'm doing the wrong button again. Oh, it's one-handed, so that would be you? That's a big boost. There you go, Cassandra. Look at the rest of the stuff later. Rod of Nor has reached level 5. Plus 2 power. There's something over here as well. There's another chest. So that was a lot easier than expected, dealing with the Templars. I was expecting to be a very long-winded quest. Onyx. So let's see what else is in the vicinity. Do we have anything else over here? Well, that's a long ways away. The Drufflo Rome cave. Hmm. still got all that ram's meat to find. Rifts. Apostate caches. You know what? I don't know what any of this is. What do we got? Why don't we do these rifts on the outskirts? And close those, and maybe we'll call this an episode. And then next episode, maybe we should go meet up with the Chantry, as Silas keeps suggesting here. Alright, so I should mark it on the map before I brought us here, but... this rift on the outskirt? Yeah, let's go here. So I'm going to the one further north to start. And my system is whirring up quite loudly, quite nicely now. That's fun. Hopefully you can't hear it over the mic. If you can, I apologize.
Watch your step.
Another chest loot. That one only hurt a little bit. Come on, walk up that hill. More elf root. Need to start watching that compass for blue dots.
Oop. Hopefully the Inquisition can find some way to help these people.
I'm working on it. Looks like heading north takes us through the camp. Through the town.
Thank you.
It's good to have commerce restored.
I'm guessing I'm gonna have to go up and around for this. This looks kind of official. Exclamation point. There are so many quests in this area. I don't know how we're gonna get through all of it. And not feel like we're just sitting still.
Something anyway. They're blocking the road.
They might not be bandits.
You don't think they're bandits?
Bandits wait until people are vulnerable, then hit them fast so nobody escapes. These bastards show themselves too early. They care more about driving people away than taking loot. They're either stupid, or they're more than just bandits. And they're too well armed for stupid.
Tell me about them.
What can you tell me about the attackers on the road?
Several groups, some of them with bows. They've got better armor than most around here. It's too many for us. If you head out there, careful you don't get flanked. They don't take prisoners.
All right, thanks for the info.
Thanks for the warning.
But I'm here for Fade Rifts. Pass.
Is even terrain too much to ask for?
Is there a problem?
Well, you might be used to traipsing through the countryside, punching dragons, interrogating people, or whatever it is you did before this. I'm from the city.
Funny. There it is. Nope. Potion. What was the Phaedra? I don't know why I was having a hard time focusing on it. I wanted to disrupt it earlier. Let's see what goodies left behind. Shadow Essence. Enhanced Leaping Shot Ring. Another quest just over here. So let's grab this before we head back down. Close the last rift, or the second of the two rifts, whichever it is. Not really the last. Also, I'm seeing a blue dot, which could mean a ram. So let's take our buddy over here. What am I looking for? Square? No. And no. I mean, do you drop velveteen? I'm just killing random animals at this point, hoping. Fennec fur. Yeah, that kind of feels like murder. Pointless just to see what kind of crap you can get from it. Alright, so this little house up here has got some sort of quest or challenge or info or something for me. Ooh, this looks well kept. Except for the garbage. Someone was home recently, though. Fire's still lit, and torches are all on. A letter in an abandoned home. Not very recently abandoned. The stone calls to me. In my dreams, I shape it with chisel and hammer. It shapes me in return. My flesh twists, claws and fangs ripping forth. The light in the sky makes the stone so much louder. The cave in the hills is a good, strong stone. I can shape it to something strong enough to keep me safe if I hurry. Jendon, if you're having the dreams, go talk to the Templars. The war doesn't matter. Their job is to help when things are too frightening to deal with alone. And the only reason the Templars didn't find you as a child is because your parents hid you away. If carving helps you, here's a map to an old cave I stumbled on a few years back. I think it has the stone you like. Interesting. I don't know how long this place has been abandoned, but it seems like an awful long time to abandon something that's still got a lit fire. Here, horsey, horsey. Wonder why it always appears behind your character. Suppose it was probably just easier to code that way. More fennec. I'm looking for rams. What is the plural for ram? Would it be rams? I'd say I have to look that up, but we all know I'm not going to bother looking that up. It seems like a silly thing to bother looking up. Blue dots in town. Meh, not going to go through the effort. Heading, I guess it'd be south at this point, looking for. Oop. That looks interesting. Kind of like a side alcove thing. I'll just leave the same area. There's some iron there, but I have a feeling we've probably got plenty of iron. House that had that green. Thing door. Nope. This one's openable. And we've already been here. Pretty sure we came from this direction in general. Oop, Alfred. I see that there. Sitting in that grass. See what I did there? Hear what I did there? No. Doesn't really matter. And we're heading for this rift at this point. Up the hill or around the hill? Fennec. Oh, ram. Ram. Yay! All this effort and finally got another one. A whopping 3 meat. Ooh, look at the ram. Trying to take these out with a melee character just wasn't working. Oh, jeez. Serious, good for ram's meat. Do you not drop any? That's sad. Apparently that ram had no meat on its bones. Or no bones, because usually when it drops bones. Fennec running away, yep. Another one over here, yep. Oh, we got a quest right here. What is this quest? Randwich. Oh, what is this? Dead Templar? Dead Mage? Sketch of Callenhad's foothold. Oh, there's so much stuff. So much stuff. Drop me meat. Yes. 5 ransom. Oh, God. I'm happy we randomly stopped here because I imagine with how slow I was collecting ram's meat, it would have taken me a rather long time to find everything we needed. I've already got some fennec fur, might as well collect some more. Need to find a way to upgrade Bianca, I think. Sick. From what I understand, several of the characters have custom weapons. Nope. South. There we go. Alright, they don't pull. Every time I click on it, I frickin' jump. I love that that does damage. Makes me want to do it a heck of a lot more when this is happening. Not early enough. Boom. All stunned. I need to get myself a charge attack at some time. 2 damage? No. No damage. Fair enough. It's 2 waves. Close rift. This all appear to be two kind of waves, and some are 3. I don't know if it's a rhyme or reason, or if it has to do with level of difficulty. More influence, and a quest completed. And more power. Oh, hello.
Templar bastards killed my husband and stole the ring from his finger. They deserve to die.
I'm sorry, they did what?
You're saying the Templars attacked your husband?
Aye. He was digging out a stump. The fools couldn't tell a shovel from a mage's staff. Had to be safe, they said. Rebels everywhere attacking by surprise, sick bastards. They took the ring I gave him on our wedding day in case it was magic.
Well, that's just disgusting.
Farewell.
I'll do what I can to get it back for you. Ooh, look, more rams. Miss entirely. No, killed him. Just didn't see the hate. Someone's in combat. Where?
Where did?
Am I attacking my own teammate there? I totally am. Get over here.
The apostates have fled to the hills.
What is this? Looted caravan of some kind.
You never did tell me why you dragged me to Haven, Seeker. I mean, what could I have told the Divine that you couldn't say yourself?
I thought she needed to see the chest tear for herself.
I say again?
I thought she needed to hear it from the horse's mouth, as it were. I also knew she would ask you to help us.
Help the Inquisition? Me?
That's what you're doing, isn't it?
A crazy thought, I know. Yet here you are.
Exactly. For example, all the hunting you're doing for me right now. Eight of ten. Let's do a quick look for some more RAM, and let's turn this in. And then, pop back to the Inquisition Stronghold. One more RAM. Let's mark town on our map and head back that way. It's a crossroads. No. I just want to mark it. I'm gonna head back that way. Unless this is a RAM right here we just saw on the radar temporarily. It disappeared. Alright, so heading back towards the crossroads. So the RAMs appear to be... another Fennec. Spending way more time than I should in collecting this ram's meat. On this episode, ram's meat collection. Climb out! We'll go around. Okay. As if I managed to get it with a long sword. Two-handed sword, great sword, whatever you want to call it. Head down this slope. That's a more, I was about to say that's a more gentle slope, but it's just a just giant frickin' drop. Oop. Templar? No apostate. We're gonna just kind of leave them be. I have a feeling that the Templars in general have kind of disappeared because we finished off the camp. This ram's meat, yay! Now we'll just run frickin' straight back. We can stop butchering innocent animals. So much effort. We need to swing by the apothecary and see if we can make some upgraded potions or some new potions. And we need to level everyone up as well. So I think we'll swing by the crossroads here. And then for the end of the episode we'll do some boring item management and maybe make some potions. And those of you that stick around for that, well, why? I'll record it anyway, but I don't expect anyone to sit around and watch that kind of crap. So much to loot. I have a feeling that's gonna wear thin very quickly. And I'm going to stop collecting so much. But as of right now, the novelty of having a great deal of items is... Well, it's a novelty. So, where was that hunter? It's up here, right? Bet you that's him right there on the radar. Still got this poor man whose wife can't breathe. Ooh, elf root in town. Nobody picks this stuff? Like... It's it have no value unless you're an actual alchemist or something? You, sir. I want to give you stuff.
Mages, Templars, bandits, demons. Making it hard for a man to hunt for his supper.
Well, here you go.
Here. Maybe this will help.
It more than helps. With this, I can fill these hungry bellies. Give these folks some hope. I didn't think much of the Inquisition. But no one else is helping like you lot. Maybe I was wrong.
More power. Yay. Alright. Map. Let's head back to world map. Let's head back to the Haven. And see what we can do. Okay, so we're back here. Drop me outside. Let's, let's do some item management stuff. Let's hit, swing by the blacksmiths here. And
have you seen the horses Master Dent sent to the Inquisition? They're magnificent.
What does it want me to do here? Modify weapons, craft armor. Modify armor. Craft weapons. There we go. Craft weapons. Okay, so what do we got here? The Ferelden longsword and the Templar longsword. Greatsword, sorry. I don't know why I'm calling them longswords. This has got way better DPS. So let's make a Templar. Each crafting schematic has one or more slots. Each slot accepts a specific number of materials, either a metal, cloth, or leather. Fill in all available slots to craft an item. There are five different types of crafting slots: utility, offense, defense, damage, and armor. The type of slot determines the stat that will be granted from the material placed in it. For example, placing iron in defense slot gives a bonus to melee defense, while putting it in the utility slot gives a bonus to strength. Experiment with different combinations of materials and slots to create unique items that fit your needs. Okay, well, predetermined stat value for each possible slot type, which you can view by examining the material. Finally, the value of the stat coming from the slot is determined by the multiplying this value by the number of materials placed in the slot. So we got a lot of iron. This gives me 118 damage, 118 damage. So there's no difference in damage. Let's go with the one we got the most of for that. What is this? A utility slot? Plus 6 strength, plus 6 constitution. So that would be kind of like health or toughness, or, well, let's go with the constitution because I have a feeling we probably could use it. Enduring Greatsword. Let's rename it to Big Sharp Thing. Let's just call it First Sword. Sword. And accept. Okay. So is it made? Completed a quest. Modify weapons? So what is modifying exactly? Oh, we can add stuff to it. So you grip, pommel, or rune for a sword.
You need something?
Interesting. Okay, so let's just throw on the new sword we made. Let's see where that stands. That's significantly better. I wonder if there's armor we can make that's better as well. But for now, we're just gonna go with the Grot. Let's swing by the alchemist shop, see what we can do with all this elf fruit we found, and then next episode, let's go talk to the priesthood, whatever it's called. I can't recall at this point. I will start off next episode by talking to everyone and seeing how they're doing. Upgrade potions. You can upgrade potions you have already unlocked. To upgrade a potion, select a category, select a potion, then select the upgrade. Potion upgrades require a significant amount of herb to unlock. In return, they give permanent and significant bonuses to your potions. So, healing potion. I need to find a Dawn Lotus. I don't have any. Useful. Regeneration. Increase duration or increase healing. Increase duration by 8 seconds. Increase amount by 3 per second. Let's go with both. And maybe we'll have to start using our regeneration potion before going in on things like tonic stuff. I haven't unlocked any tonics. Grenades. Haven't unlocked any grenades.
Sigrid can get that.
You're back. And in one piece.
How are things?
How are your people holding up?
We've got Mother Giselle lending a hand now, which helps. For the ones that need comforting more than actual healing, she's a rock in fast water. Something to cling to.
Goodbye.
Farewell.
Equip potions. Generation. So, looking forward to this grenade thing. Alright, well, let's just, let's call that an episode, and next time we will go see the Chantry. That's what they're called, the Chantry. So for the end of this episode here, we're going to stand next to the bard here. Hopefully she's going to play something, and we'll do some equipment stuff. And of course, it doesn't play while we're in the menus. That sucks. I was hoping for some nice music. Okay, I'm thinking maybe some Vanguard. Let's do some more. We're kind of on this trait right now. Crippling blows. You know how to take the fight out of your foes. Critical hit leaves the enemy weakened. I don't know how often we can depend on a critical hit. Hamstring. When you attack a target from behind, you leave them slowed. So that could lead to combat roll. That could be useful. What have we got? Coup de grace, you deal more damage against enemies that are stunned or knocked down. Better them than you. Bonus damage. Horn of Valor, your war horn blasts. Ring across the battlefield, giving allies strength to fight harder. What's the other one over here? War horn, your war horn blasts with fear into the hearts of your foes, leaving them panicked. Deep reserves. Breath back faster than most. When your stamina is very low, it regenerates more quickly. That's really useful. What about... Oop, that's not what I meant to do at all. We've got Warcry. Draw strength from your Warcry, improving your armor for the coming fight. Battle where Warcry echoes across the battlefield, catching more enemies and taunting them for longer. Guard per enemy. What's this? Untouchable defense. They can't kill what they can't hit. You get a bonus to your maximum guard. Let's do that. Let's get ourselves a lot tougher. Let's make ourselves a kind of a tanky guy. And of course, we're just going to auto-level up everyone else. Build them the way the developers meant them to be built. And then let's do some quick equipping. So we've already got Cassandra with a new weapon. Inquisition shields. There's nothing new shield-wise. Gonna be greedy here and look at my own armor first. Sturdy adventurer's hat. That doesn't really look like a hat. It's rather silly looking, actually. But let's go ahead and equip it because it's better than what we have. Heavy adventurer's armor we're already wearing. Okay, what do we got? Defender coat. Let's get some better melee defense. But that's it. Ooh, something new for you, Silas. Let's... Solas. I keep calling you Silas. I don't know where I'm getting Silas from. Solas. Let's equip you with the apprentice mail. And an elven cowl. Varric. We already found some rather nice armor for you, but that's even better. Even better. Okay, so let's do weapons for Solas and... Shocking Staff 37, 32, 28. Okay, and you've got your Bianca, which we don't want to change. These are better DPS, but you're not a melee fighter. Alright, so accessories. We've got the Amulet of Power, Varric only, Rogue only. Increased ability damage by 30%. Oh, yes, please. Token of the Packmaster, 2% Sunder on hit. Sunder, what is... Sunder on hit, Sunder when hit. Grenade spell, increase the max capacity of all grenades by the specified amount. Guard belts, maximum guard by the specified amount. Let's let's go with a guard belt. Oh, click once. And then, Packmaster. I didn't have another ring, did I? Guard penetration? For now. Give you a belt of sunder. Ring of barrier penetration. You keep getting yourself hurt. Let's give you a life ward amulet. I'm sure it gets destroyed on use. You've got everything here, so let's see. Gain an ability point when equipped. Single use. Amulet of power. Ability duration by 30%. Give you that. Ability duration by 30%. Give you that. Ability damage. Okay, so let's do ability damage and duration. And let's give you the grenade belt because why not? And that's that. Nope. Accessories. We went through yours, didn't we? Yeah, we got nothing else. So thanks for joining us today. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and we'll see you guys next time. Take care, all.